spend around a lakh and above on just on mods. Let's just get into it.
So let's just start off from the front.
The first thing that I've done on the bike is, let's start with the front.
And the first thing that you notice immediately
is that the brake pads on the Himalayan are not something to my taste. I did give it some decent time on the road, testing it. But then it turned out to be a big disaster.
See here is, these are EBC brake pads. They have a very strong bite, and not only that, if you see the material that they use on these pads are sintered, and what that means is it has a very strong heat dissipation rate, and just clings on to the disc plate very strongly. One good thing about the Royal Enfield Himalayan is it comes stock with a steel brake hose, so the pressure transfer is almost instant. It's just that the brake pad material was a little too low quality, or God knows what. So if anybody is interested in trying this particular brake pad out, kindly do so. Pretty easy to remove the old ones and install the new ones. All you need to do is remove these two bolts, get the caliper assembly out, pull it out from this particular bracket, and then the rest of it is just pretty self-explanatory. You don't have to think so much on how to go about it, or there are millions of videos online which show you how to go about it, and anyone with amateur level skill set can do this. So that's the first mod on the motorcycle. Then we move on to, yeah, there you go. I did this particular mod on the mudguard. What I did is I chopped off about, let's just say, 4 inches of the frontal portion. And why did I do that? Technically speaking, I'm the lower the surface area on the mudguard, the lesser slush and mud getting into it and staying there, and so there's very little friction for the wheel to spin. So moving on to the third mod would be this particular spotlight, aux light, spotlight, whatever you want to call it. I got it off Amazon for about $1,500. Very high quality, I would say, for $1,500. There are Denali ones that sell for about, let's just say, 30,000 rupees in Indian money. And I have seen them work. They are pretty strong, but these fellows are about, let's say, 70% of good Denali spotlight. So when you get 70% light output for nearly one-tenth the price of the market leader, then you should grab it. Another thing that always was there in my mind was the quality of the lamp. Yes, that is debatable. Why is because everything else is rock solid except for the fact that they are not waterproof. So water tends to get in through this groove and you start seeing moisture collecting here in this portion. So what I did for that was, it was a simple fix. If you watch here, you will see screws. There are three screws, one here, one here, and one here. I opened them up. I got this outer cover out and went in with a coat of silicone, put it back in, screwed them up, and from then on it has been waterproof for about a year and a half now. If you can see, crystal clear, not a speck inside. Everything else, any bit of dirt that you see is on the outside. It's a proper fix. The next mod would be, of course you saw me put out a video on painting the ring black, and I'm super happy and convinced with what I did. So that's just, I would not consider it a mod, but then again, it is a modification, isn't it? An aesthetic mod.
or cosmetic mod. Moving on to the next one, the most important mod on the motorcycle that I've done is swap the factory halogen bulb to the Cyclops LED. This particular model has a very similar cutoff pattern to the stock factory halogen. So if anybody has things to say, like, you know, that and the light output is going to be too scattered and all that jazz, they are wrong. This translates into a hell of a lot of light throw on the road. And if you just know how to tilt the headlamp a little forward, pretty easy, loosen these bolts on both the sides and tilt the headlamp a little forward like I've done. I've gotten a little more of clearance and I've tilted it forward. If you just do that much, then light from this particular headlamp will not blind the oncoming traffic. Definitely worth every single rupee that you spend. Moving on to the fourth mod in the same line of travel, I would say this, it's a wind deflector. It's an additional piece that you add on to the stock windshield. I always found the stock windshield to be a little too short for me. I'm 5'10 and a half, and I would always have wind hitting me on my eyes, exactly on my eyes, if I were to just lift the visor of the helmet. So got this off Amazon, paid $1,400 for this. I'm amazed at what you get these days for very little money. It's a aluminium, how do I say, CNC cut contraption, which has this. You can lower the lever and raise the height. And once you're happy with that, all you need to do is just close it in place, and this does its job. Ever since I fixed this onto the windshield, never had issues of wind hitting me on my eyes. Yeah, I like the lowest setting because that's all I need. Yeah, let's start it. Moving on to the next mod. The next mod would be handguards from KTM. These are stock factory handguards on the KTM motorcycle. I don't have a very strong opinion on them because they are plastic. Eventually they will break. Even if it breaks, it's very readily available. You don't have to wait for you know, a day or two for it to be shipped from somewhere. You get it instantly. Go to any showroom, ask for these handguards, and they are almost always available. So I'm definitely planning on getting Bark Busters in some time. Quite expensive, so just waiting for the right time, planning my finances, and I will have the Bark Busters on. Talking about these are KTM bar ends for the KTM handlebar. I have the KTM handlebar, the KTM 390 handlebar on the machine. I'll tell you why, there's a reason to it. Any which ways, let's come back to the bar ends. The bar ends are amazing. Two pieces. What I have next is a armrest. You can call it cramp buster, you can call it all sorts of things. But this particular thing has helped a lot in long rides, especially on the highways. They don't do much on off-road. In fact, off-road you ought to be removing them because they are hindrance on off-road terrain. You don't really understand the exact throttle position with them on. So always good to get rid of them during off-road rides. But on highways, long stretches of roads where you want to reduce the amount of pressure that you put into twisting the throttle and you want to hold a constant speed, this particular thing just does wonders for you. Moving on to the next mod, these are wonderful mods from Double Take, and oh my, I don't really know how they've how to tell you the way these play a huge role in all sorts of terrains and hardy, extremely hardy mirrors. They come with a RAM mount system, and what I have here is a universal lock. This needs a particular key which you will find on my keychain. So it works like this. I put it in and then I can twist and turn to reduce or increase the tension between these two RAM hands or RAM arms. So the idea behind a double take is it's an adjustable mirror. Like you can see, you can adjust it the way you want. That's the best part of having a double take mirror. Apart from that, the way these things add to the aesthetic appeal of the machine. Like you can see, they just transform the machine. They make the machine look so much more aggressive, and they have a very unique character to them. This particular shape is something that you would never come across anywhere. So you can definitely know for a fact that that is one authentic piece of design on your motorcycle. Coming back to the next mod, what you see here is the X-Grip mounting system, more like the RAM system, but this I got before I got the original ones. This is a fake one, again a Chinese replica. Again, 1200 or 1300 bucks. And what you get is you get a charger, USB port, which puts out 5 volts, and I've tested it on my iPhone for about almost 2 years now. Everything works really, really well. Simple mechanism again. If you see, adjustable, you can adjust it the way you want in all possible directions. I would say 360 degrees. Again, works very similar to the RAM arm system. In fact, this is a RAM replica. And that's that. The next thing in line is the KTM handlebar. These are kind of fat bars. By that I mean they're fat in the center and they taper down on both the sides, and so you know for a fact that, and these are also alloy bars. They're very, very they're almost about the same weight, or in fact lesser than the stock Himalayan handlebar, and they're far, far more resilient and strong. What you see here is a handlebar riser. This helped me a lot, again with the standing up position, and I'll just show you what I mean.
So with the handlebar riser, I can comfortably saddle like this. My hand used to be here, so I hold the motorcycle like that. Now I'm pretty comfortable. You get to see this back here, which is kind of important when you do rolls, because if you've got some movement here, it helps with maneuver. And but with the previous position, my hands were almost straight, and now it's really much better. So that's how I off-road. I'm pretty comfortable. I can do all sorts of things the whole day. Just 2 inches of height that I managed to gain. I've completely controlled the motorcycle. It feels much, much better.
So that's about 2 inches of height that I've gained. If you can see, the stock bar position was there and now it is here, so it gives you exactly 2 inches of height. And I'll tell you, this will make a big difference for anybody who's 5'8" and taller. This will help you a lot. Moving on to the next one, 12 volt power adapter. So I run two USB. I run an additional adapter onto this, which runs two USB charging outlets. So I am good with one, two, and three. Three charging outlets from the motorcycle is more than sufficient for all sorts of things that you plan on doing. The next thing is a map switch from Race Dynamics. I run Race Dynamics ECU, more like a piggyback system. which I have placed here. I'll come to that in some time. So the wiring kit includes a wiring harness which runs underneath the motorcycle tank, and then you also have a switch coming to the front which has a map 1 and map 2 as options. So I usually run on map 1 when I want the vehicle to be giving better fuel economy and for city use. Map 2 is where I really want to push the motorcycle hard. Map 2 is more towards the higher band of power. Map 1 is from the lower bands to the mid RPMs. That's that. Another switch for the aux light or the spotlight to come on. That's the switch for the light. And yep, that's all that you see on the handlebar. The next mod is this tank grip, or you can call them stomp grips. This particular shape is custom made. What I did was I got a CBR 250R tank grip, which was that big, and it was a weird shape, so I chopped it down to something like this. When I am off-roading and trying to grip the tank, this is the portion where my knee, my calf, my thigh, this is the region where I make contact with the tank. And so I did not want to go ahead and stick something that big, that large. So I cut it into this shape, tried to mimic the shape of the tank, and got and this one done. So it has these spikes, if you can see. The whole thing is made of rubber. It has these spikes stuck with 3M double-sided tape. That does the job for you. I have a gear shift lever rubber insert. The stock rubber that comes with the shaft is very low quality. It leaves marks on your footwear, and this just saves that hassle, that headache. So moving on to, there's a Canon filter in the airbox. That's something that doesn't need any introduction. It's a high flow performance air filter which lets in a lot more of air into the motorcycle. And to compensate for the lack of fuel, I have the Race Dynamics piggyback ECU, which does the job of making the mixture the right proportion for the engine to burn. Moving on to the other side. Again, on this side what you find is the tank grip. And what I have here is the iridium spark plug. It's the NGK iridium spark plug, which where I also have this is a Spitfire ignition cable. It's a very high conducting cable. It has by that I mean it just conducts electricity way more quickly. It creates a bigger, more stronger spark. And the ignition, the NGK iridium spark plug is also something that will definitely help with better combustion, because the spark firing order is very quick. It fires very quickly, and it is it's a universally known fact about the iridium plugs that they outlast at times the life of the motorcycle. So a good investment there.